As they approached the colossal creature, their optimism faded. It did not seem to like them at all. And now they realized what terrible danger they were in. If this creature guarded the way to some holy place, then that place must lie below it. And being so large, the creature most likely could not see what was in front of it or beneath it. So perhaps the size of the trebhum was an advantage after all. Perhaps they could reach the platform right under the serpent's head. Relieved at having bested the Guardian, the trebhum now found themselves seeking the help they had been promised. Who would answer their questions in this place? Even with the light, the maze was difficult to traverse. Was there some clue in the structures on the walls? Was the path of sand on the ground meant to help them? Perhaps others had walked in this place long ago and tried to leave a path for those who would one day follow them. Thank you. encountering another elder was a happy moment. The trebhum asked how they might survive the cylinder, and the elder replied, "I can feel your fear, little ones. Ever since this cataclysm began, we have been seeking ways to stop it. But the cylinder is relentless and indestructible. It will consume everything in its path. So, perhaps what we need to do is go behind it. I have discovered a mutation that allows us to rise into the sky. You must seek a weeping tree from which grows a special fruit that floats as it becomes ripe. It is the key to the transformation I have undergone. With it, you can use geysers to float well above the cylinder's height. My only regret is that I have grown too old and weak to help you with this task. If you find any glimmer of hope on the other side, remember me. Farewell." Sadness and fear filled the Trebhum's hearts as they left the Elder's cave. Their only path to salvation was full of uncertainty, and they could not forget the thing they had seen lurking behind the cylinder, casting a dark shadow over this glimpse of light. The Trebhum had never seen this mysterious tree the Elder spoke of. They would have to keep moving forward and hope it lay somewhere ahead. The cylinder would give them no other choice. Thank you.
Thank you.
They were still nowhere near the mysterious tree they were supposed to find. But the voice and their memories encouraged them. It was wise in matters of root and rock, and it could sense the soil under their feet changing. Step by step, they were getting closer.
Thank you. Thank you.